The Hundred Dresses. A letter to readers. When I am asked about my mother's book, The Hundred Dresses, I often wonder what to say. What more meaning could my words give to a book that, although written 60 years ago, continues to reach the hearts of children around the world? What answers could I give the children who still write letters of thanks and praise to my mother? Is this a true story, they ask? Did this happen to you? Well, most stories are based on both fact and fiction, and certainly this is true for The Hundred Dresses. Years ago, I asked my mother why she had written the story. She told me about a classmate in her elementary school who had been taunted because she wore the same dress to school every day, and because her Polish name was unusual and difficult for many to pronounce. My mother was in school during World War I, and Polish names were uncommon then in the small town of West Haven, Connecticut, where my mother grew up and where the story takes place. Her classmate wore the same dress to school each day because it was the only one she had. This little girl moved away to New York City in the middle of the school year, and my mother, as sometimes happens in real life, did not have the opportunity to tell her she was sorry. My mother never forgot the little girl who had been so badly treated. She herself knew what it was like to be poor as a child, to always be cold in winter, to wear clothes passed down to her by her sister. But was this a reason to tease or be teased? Was it right to play with the feelings of one who is different? What could she do so many years later? My mother wondered, to set things right, to reach out to the girl who had stood lonely and silent against the red brick wall of the school. Well, she thought, the one thing she could do was to write her story. And so The Hundred Dresses was born. Was the character Maddie based on my mother? Probably. Did Wanda really have 100 dresses at home? Certainly in her imagination she did. Decades later, The Hundred Dresses is still loved by children. Not long ago, I received a letter from a little girl in Southern California. She was especially moved by Wanda's ability to forgive. She wrote, "Seeing people for themselves from the inside is one lesson I learned from Wanda." She forgave both Peggy and Maddie, even though she had to put up with them every day. I am grateful to all the children who continue to love this extraordinary story. May The Hundred Dresses live on for many, many more years. Helena Estes.